Hey guys, Raj Sanger of Cardio Security. Welcome back to the channel and welcome to another Cars and Coffee Meet here at Cardio Security. First Cars and Coffee Meet of 2022, and it is sold out. We are expecting 70 cars here. There's no specific brand or genre. It literally is bring what you want, classic, modern classic, supercar, new car, whatever. Just bring what you want. Today's about mingling, talking to like-minded individuals, having a coffee, having a look around our great showroom, and obviously talking to some individuals. So I'm gonna go outside, grab three or four people, see if they're prepared to come on the channel and talk about their car and talk about their journey. So let's get outside. Guys, let's start with a brand that's very close to my heart. It's a sunny day, so why not come out in a Speed Yellow 993? Now, this gorgeous car belongs to George.
Hey, Raj. Nice
okay, hold on. You. This gorgeous car belongs to Dr. George. Pardon. Sorry, Dr. George. Sorry, didn't want to offend you there.
No problem.
Now, George has driven down from Warwickshire?
Yeah, mate. Yeah.
So, and he was one of the ones that was here quite early, I think probably nearly an hour before we opened. So, appreciate you coming down. Talk to me about this 993.
I've been looking forward to coming down all week actually. So I've wanted Speed Yellow RS for a long, long time. Everyone knows the price has just gone way out of hand for something that I could enjoy and ever get to enjoy. Yeah. I come across this car, been built as a club sport would be. There's only 23 right-hand drive ever made for a club sport RS.
Guys, he's obviously done his homework, you know.
So that was never going to happen. I get to enjoy this. Everything's been done other than a battery cutoff switch on the dash. So
that's
me,
all been done it. Prior to you purchasing the car.
Everything's
been
done.
You bought the car as is.
As is. And I'm going to enjoy it for what it is. Going to get my wheels done with Ellie at Voodoo.
Okay. Ellie, that's another customer your way. Just remember that. I'm notching up some points here, so I need a free set of wheels soon, okay?
And it's great to have, obviously, next to such bright coloured cars today as well. So,
talk me through the car. It's a 3.6?
3.8.
3.8, so it's a 3.8?
Yeah, RS 3.8.
Oh,
original
wow.
GT Classic, provide the engine, so it's an RS 3.8 block, as a proper one would be. Single mass flywheel, cage as per OEM welded in, proper fabric, fire retardant seats, all done properly.
I've got to say, it is a stunning car. No carpet?
Nothing.
No sand deadening?
Nothing.
It's just you and the car?
That's it, yeah.
Oh, this must be insane to drive. I think at some point I need to go out with Dr. George and see what this car feels like, because it must be an animal. Now, another thing, there's a reason why George is here. He's also got a CSL, an M3 CSL. So another car that's sort of close to my heart. Now, I think we need to move on. This is a fantastic car. We will get George on the channel again at some point, maybe in the CSL as well, because I know you've had that for a while.
Yeah.
Really appreciate you coming down.
Oh,
we'll throw
you.
Some cinematics of this car because it is just absolutely stunning. Appreciate you coming.
Cheers, buddy. Thanks so
and,
much.
And thanks for coming on the channel.
Thank you.
Staying with the theme of Porsches and staying with bright cars, 964 in ruby stone, probably one of the best colors out there, maybe after Speed Yellow, I don't know. You know, let me know down below, what would you prefer, ruby stone or Speed Yellow in these classic Porsches? Now this gorgeous 964 belongs to a good friend of ours and a customer of ours. He knows a little bit about paint as well, so come on Tom, don't be shy.
You're all right.
Tom, welcome to the channel.
Thank you, man.
I've seen this car numerous times. It is a fantastic car. Talk me through the journey. Did it start as a ruby stone car?
No, it was red originally. So
okay.
It was a Carrera 4. I got it, I think about 8 years ago.
Okay.
Fully stripped it down, did a few mods to it. And yeah, changed the color to my favorite color, which as you can tell is ruby stone from all my company logos.
So, it certainly does pop in the sunlight. Yeah. You know, it's fantastic color. I mean, some people say you've got to be brave to be driving around in a
pink Porsche.
Pink Porsche, yeah. But I think as classic Porsches go, this is one of the best colours and an iconic colour as well.
Yeah.
Any other mods you've done? I'm sure there are like...
903 Scuttle.
Okay.
Obviously no number plate. The cup mirrors on there.
Yes.
The DTM style ones.
I don't think these do anything. Come on,
they
really?
They don't. They don't, mate. You can just about see out of this one. The other one you can't see out of at all. And RS rear screen.
Yep.
And then I did a custom rear bumper with a shortened number plate on there as well.
It's still a stock 3.6?
Yep, still standard engine.
And any other plans for this car?
Tidy it up some more and then put it up for sale.
I understand that you've got a pretty cool project that you're working on.
Yes.
Do you want to tell the guys what that is?
Yeah, so it's a Carrera 2, 1990 convertible. And I'm making it into a coupe. And it's going to be Ruby Stone again. But it'll be a full-on stripped down nut and bolt rebuild.
Now that's totally unusual. Yeah. So guys, if you want to learn more about that project, give Tom a follow, his details are down below, and watch the journey of that. I mean, even I'm watching that car, so that's a pretty cool journey. Tom, thanks for coming.
Thanks, mate.
And I'll see you again soon.
Yeah, cheers buddy.
Remember what I said earlier, there's just like an amazing mix of cars in the car park. Golfs, Mercs, Lambos, and then something so cool that we had to get it on the channel. A Merc R129, which belongs to Harry.
Nice to meet you.
Thanks for coming.
You're right.
Wow, the moment this rocked in, myself, the staff, they're like, oh my god.
Got an offer straight away, so I know, want to buy it.
I know the couple of staff have already come up to you. Is it for sale? Yeah. So you're probably going to get a lot today and probably in the comments down below. But wow. Talk to me about this car, the journey, because obviously you've not bought it like this, have you?
No. No.
Okay, so what have you done?
So I brought it last June, I think it was. When have you tons of them before I
found
like
one
that
actually liked. Purchase.
Yeah, I had an M4 before.
Okay.
Got done with that, fancy something different, a little bit more of an investment. Looked at these, just love the shape of them. A bit iconic as well.
Yes.
So as soon as I brought it, within a few weeks, spoke to Intermotive, Jonathan over there, who made me a bag set up for it, 3P management all throughout. And after that I was like, right, it's gotta be wheels. Looked around for some wheels, couldn't find anything I liked. Loved the wheels, so it come on Evo 2s as standard.
Okay.
And decided I've got to have the Evo 2s made of splits. So I contacted TT Polish on Instagram, who said to me, yep, I can make you centres for them.
What size are these?
So they're an 18-inch wheel, 16-inch face.
Okay.
The standard ones are 17 on them, they come on. So he's made a 16-inch face, centre cap for them as well to hide all the hardware on it. And then obviously made them to my specs and everything.
Do you know the widths? Can you remember the
width? Yeah, 8.5 on the front, 9.5 on the rear.
They look wider on the back, to be fair.
Yeah.
They look a lot wider than 9.5.
It's a 2.5-inch dish on the front, 3.5-inch on the rear. Yeah, and then I wasn't going to originally go for as much camber and go for the look. I was going to try and go for more of a poke look, but I like the tuck and clean fitment sort of look in the end. So yeah, then had camber arms all made up for the rear from a local company. Cambered adjustable top mounts made as well by Intermotive. And yeah, and then yesterday was the first time letting it out in public.
Oh really? Okay.
Yeah, this is the first time it's ever been seen in public.
You know what? I appreciate you bringing
car. That's all right.
Today, fantastic day for it as well.
Yeah, exactly.
Great turnout.
Yeah.
Fantastic car. No doubt we'll see it at many other shows. We're going to have a Mercedes event here soon, so make sure you come to that as well.
Yeah, get me on the list, definitely.
Stunning car, guys. Yeah. Harry's details are down below, so if you want to just send him loads of spam, is the car for sale, by all means do
I'm
that.
I'm taking GT3s or swaps.
Thanks for coming, Harry. Thanks for coming. Guys, let's end on something different. Typically, we have Ford, we have VAG, we have BMs, we have Mercedes, we have Porsches, but never have we had something as cool as this Chevy truck on the channel. Let me introduce you to Nate.
How you doing? You
thanks right? for coming. Yeah,
no worries. Thank you very much.
This is just amazing.
Yeah, now it's a bit different.
Have you bought it like this, or have you done all the work to it?
I would like to say I have, but I haven't.
Okay, is, at least you're honest.
Yeah, it's I found it about 45 minutes away.
Firstly,
from my
what
house.
Is it? It's a Chevrolet truck.
Yeah, Chevy C10.
C10.
Yeah, 1965. Okay.
65 so, C10. Yeah. Sorry, you were saying you bought it in this condition?
Yeah, pretty much. Apart from the rear bed, which okay. I've redone all myself.
Okay.
It come as you see it on airlift manual suspension, re-trimmed interior.
Engine size?
5.8. Small block Chevy.
I would say, does it go? But it's a big thing. It's a big beast.
Surprisingly, third okay. gear. Once it's in third, she pulls. It's very torquey. Like okay. a very torquey engine. So.
Off camera, he mentioned to me that it's a manual, which
yes.
I think is fairly rare. Is that real?
They are quite rare, but also a pain in the arse.
Yeah, like, I can imagine just to get it from first into second gear and so on. And it's a big old thing.
Yes.
Now, what are the plans for this truck?
Probably change the wheels.
Okay.
Go for like a Detroit steel, like a big solid monoblock wheel, and then it would just be a body drop to get it completely sat on the floor.
Oh, so you want it literally on the floor?
I want it to lay chassis, yeah. So.
Wow, that should be super cool. Who's doing the work?
I'm yet to find someone.
Okay.
Because it is quite a big job. Like the chassis on the back has to be C-sectioned and cut away, and the bed's got to be raised another 5 inches. It's just a lot of work, which I'm not that clever.
Like, I think we need to get this truck back on the channel when the work is done. It's on airlift. We'll see the new wheels slammed on the floor.
Yep.
Hopefully have some audio in there as well.
But at the moment, I've just got a little Bluetooth speaker. So
okay,
yeah,
I think that needs to change, guys.
Yeah. You
know, that's what we do here. Nate, thanks for coming.
That's
really
right,
appreciate
no
you bringing the
thanks
truck
for having me. Thank you very much.
This is super cool.
Everyone, can I have your attention? 30 seconds, speech time. We've teamed up with Maguire's this year to give away some goodies at every event.
Coffee meet of 2022 done. Been an eventful morning. We've got Rocky Patel playing his spaceman in the background. Fantastic turnout, 70 plus cars. Now, we have decided this year that all of our Car and Coffee events will be hosted via the Eventbrite app. So make sure you follow our social media to find out when the next event is. It'll be application only. There's a £5 entry fee to have a car in our car park. And all proceeds from the car park will go to charity. So hopefully at the end of the year, we've got a good few £1,000, which we can then nominate a couple of charities and obviously send that money their way. Which car did you like today? As I said earlier, fantastic selection of cars. You know, drop your comments below. Which car did you like today? Keep an eye on our socials, as I said, for future events. Like, share, and comment, and I'll be back again pretty soon with another Car and Coffee Meet.